Yep.
Yep. Cool.
Trying to clear it.
Okay, starting out back session here. This is one I've been using lately a lot to just start it up. I always start with some kind of lat pull down or some variation of that. So this one is a single arm lat pull down. We're setting it up on the Cybex, as you can see. What the purpose of this is. So we're fully isolating just a single lat. As you can see, if you keep your shoulder down, you drive your elbow down. So you're not coming out of socket, you're keeping it low, driving the elbow low, squeezing through this low lat. So you should just be feeling this tear up right here. I can literally feel each one contract and hurt. So you wanna get to a point where you're just squeezing, pumping as much blood in there as you can before we get into our main movements. Stay tall, stay tall. Good. Here we go. They got like 4 new Texas bars.
Yeah.
Earlier and earlier, and like, well, they I had to help them get them out of the, you know, the tubes. Couldn't even fucking get them out of it. It was crazy.
Oh.
Yep, yep. Oh.
This is a throwback for me, so you guys know I've got my own home gym. Well, I have to be very careful with which pieces I pick, and I haven't yet got a pullover. But the last time I used a pullover, we'd actually, Luke and I, it's one of Luke's favorite back pieces. So it's super nostalgic for me because the last time I did it was with Luke, back in Muscle Works in London. And we started off every back session for the last year and a half that we were training together. So end of 2018, all of 2019, every back session, Dorian style pullovers with some meat on the back. And again, Luke had a back to back it up, so.
Yeah.
Brett's back, Ivana's back, take it from them. It works. Come on.
Two. Three, yep. Come on, guys. Four. Yep.
In it.
Five.
Here we go.
Six. Seven, that's it. Eight. That's good, nine. Ten.
Big. There we go. Stay tall.
Couple more.
Wow. Yes.
Two more. Two.
Yes. One more.
Yep.
Big finish.
Up.
Yes, sir. Okay.
Good job. Awesome. Okay. I think we need a new belt in here. Needs to be a tad bit smaller. More adjustment. All right. Big step for me. It's been a while.
This work. Yes. Thank you. Yes.
Need to keep working.
Yes. Yep. Good.
One more.
Good.
Okay.
Me.
Fucking A. Ooh. No comment.
And do know the purpose of this movement is for your lats. So you're growing your front lats, especially the front side. So when I come out, you know, when we do the front relaxed pose, we have those sweeping lats. That's from these pullovers. So cable pullovers, dumbbell pullovers, machine pullovers. You're working that front lat sweep right here. So that's where that comes from.
Ready? Yep.
Top set, best set. Oh, shit. Sorry. Me. You're good. I got it.
All right.
Good.
Yep.
Good?
Yeah.
So finishing up here, I want to show this one to Ben. This one's killer, especially on something. So with back, you can do a lot of different variations at the end because there's a lot of stretching involved. You can be locked into a machine, you know, with either wraps with straps or your hands. And the main thing is you can do a lot of stretching exercises with it as well. So what I call this is a stretch pause. Similar to a rest pause, except you're stretching instead of resting. So I'm going to do 10 reps with 4 plates. And then after I do 10 reps, I'm going to stretch for 10 seconds. While I'm stretching, he's gonna take one plate off. So then there's 3 plates. Then I do 10 more reps. I stretch another 10 seconds. He takes one more plate off, and I do 10 more reps. So it's 3 rounds, 10 reps each. If you can get 10, with 2 stretch pauses of 10 seconds. This is nasty, 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 and it's a way to finish off the last year.
Boom.
Yes.
Did you pull the plate?
Yeah, you're good.
Good.
Here we go. Yep.
Oh shit.
Come on, you got it.
Sorry, so three more.
Walk it out.
Two. One more.
Good.
Am I holding it? Oh, fuck.
Ready? Go.
Put some resistance on it. Yeah. Four.
Come on, fight. Good. Yeah, baby.
Yes.
One.
Wide as Fuad.
Yep.
Totally. I'm telling you. Let's go. One. Two. Four.
So we're moving on to the meat and potatoes of the workout, and that's the rows. What is it they say? They say row to grow. So I like to fill my middle of my workout with, you know, two or three different row variations. we're starting with a standing. So this is a variation. Like I said, I mix them up. Right now I'm in a phase of doing this Smith machine row. I just really like it because you can get right over it and it just drives straight up. What I'm doing in Ivana R, we're doing an undergrip. You know that old like Dorian Yates style of rowing? He loved that undergrip. So I feel like it hits the lower lats more. So we're rowing with an undergrip. Think here, your knees are pretty much straight and you're not doing any leg drive. So there's no leg movement at all. You're locked in, you're bent over, you're driving your elbows through your midline, up over your back. So you'll see Ben, he's gonna do overgrip because his wrist is a little fucked up. But you'll see both of us are just gonna ride this. We'll try to hit, you know, this is one exercise I've been logging. So I'm gonna try to hit a new PR today and we'll see what we can get.
Here we go. Yep. Yep. Have it back. Good. Good. Yes. Big squeeze. That's good. Come on. Great base, great base. Come on. Good. Good through. Come on. You got more. More. Yes. Here we go. Few more. Big one. Good.
Here we go. Yes. Yeah, come on. Come on. Yeah, deep. Now, come on. Yeah.
Ooh. Oh, weird. Put your little bag off. A squeeze or two. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
One more.
I just noticed, so Ivana's just popped off and she left her
belt on the floor. It doesn't look real, it looks so small.
You're right, it looks like one of those gas key rings. Yeah, that's crazy. It's like the Wilkins, the team household of tiny waists.
I don't know, she's on. She's got the invisible weight. All right, moving on to this bad boy right here. So this is a Cybex row machine. So you can hit, I like using it for both ways. You can either hit the neutral grip or the over the top grip. So we do over the top whenever we want to work upper back. Neutral is going to be more your mid back, rhomboids area, low lats. Today, what we're doing, since we already hit the under grip stand, bent over rows, we're coming here to do the neutral grip rows here hitting the middle of the back. And then we'll do something for higher rows to hit the upper back. So I'm all about angles. I've talked to Ben about this in my back training. We do, you know, a little bit more volume and then probably five or six exercises, but it's all about hitting all the angles of the back. So if you watch, everything is coordinated. And we started the pullovers at the front. We went low lats, mid lats, upper back. Now we'll continue this and then we'll finish with a big finish right there.
Yeah, wow. Mike.
Good. Yes. Yes. You. Good. Now we go. Good. Yep. 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 Yep.
Good. Come on, now we go. Hey, good. Yep. Good. Drive. Good. I want to drive back. Go. Hard. Yeah. Come on, I get it. Good. There we go. Come on. These are the ones. Yes. Go again. Drive. Elbows, elbows, elbows. Good, I'm one. Go, go, go. Come on, make it count. Make it count.
No, my way. Yep, yep.
Come on. Come on. Up. 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 Good. Up. Good, come on.
Up.
Good.
Up.
Good.
Up.
Come on.
One more.
Again.
Up.
Good.
Ooh. Okay, so throwing a variation here on the back off on the end. You can do this with any like usual back exercises, so your rows of any sort. We're gonna do a drop set, so two drops. So with this, I have three plates. I'm gonna go three plates, 10, two plates, 10. And then on the last plate, we're gonna focus on coming back and squeezing the contraction for 2 to 3 seconds. So each one's come back, squeeze it through. So this is all about, you know, grinding out that detail, you know, that conditioning of the back by those extended squeezes, that time under tension you hear about. This is it right here. So let's get after this.
Yep.
Get it. All the way back. Two. Three. Oh. Good.
Oh.
Ooh. Let's go. Time to go.
Yes, sir. Yep, yep.
Sexy face. Easy. There you go. Yep.
Yep.
Go three.
Yep.
Good. Drive me.
Yep.
One more.
Yep.
Good. Go, go, go. Yep. Yep. Go. And three. Come on. Take control. Take control. Three. Two. Don't rush. There you go. Yeah. We're gonna hold. 3 seconds. Good. 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 Good.
Good, come on, hold it. Go, I'm with you. Three, good, two and one. Good, Charlie, elbows back. All the way back, go. Good.
Good. Okay, moving on to our next back movement. Like I said, with our last exercise, we are working our way up now. So we are hitting the low lats, we hit the mid back. Now we are hitting the upper back with this magnum row. I really like this magnum row because you can hit all the angles with the different grips. But today I wanted to show Ben this because he's actually gonna buy this piece of equipment and how to use it with working on your upper back. So we make sure the seat is lower, our elbows are high, and you're saying you want your butt back just a little bit so your chest is forced into the pad, and then you're driving by your back. So arms go back further than your back, and then just stay locked into the pad. One of my favorite ones right here.
There you go. Good. Drive it. Yes, good, dude. Elbows dry. Elbows high and dry. Good. Line one. Good. Yup. Yup. Come on. Head up. Head up. Head up. Go again. I'm one. One. Head up. Drive. Go. Go.
Yes.
Let's work.
Come on.
Good.
Strong. Yep. Stay in it. Stay forward. There you go. Right there. Right there. Bringing you guys another variation here, so this is another back off set. I want to just kind of show you some different stuff I do. We're gonna do 1.5s, I call them. So anything that you're like chest supported in, leaning into, you know, locked into, seated, you can do 1.5s here. What that means is you do a full rep, you go half back, you stop with control, and then you drive back again. So it's 1.5, 1.5. So Ben's gonna go here first, he'll show you. But this is all about control. Lower the weight. Like I said, you already pumped all the blood into that muscle. Now we're just gonna finish it off with some kind of variation. 1.5.
Good.
Today, working on opening up my lats here on a more of a vertical plane of motion here with a pull down. Like I said before, this machine is just perfect. It really hits the lats, but you'll see breasts getting a nice big stretch at the top, opening up, driving down, hitting those lats. So just again, hitting all of those angles. This is the last one, that vertical plane of motion. I'm really getting some width and opening up those lats into a big stretch position, letting them flush with blood to finish off. Nothing crazy too heavy. We did all the heavy loading, so this one's just to finish those lats off nicely.
Good, good, good.
Good.
You know, it's good to give your body a break, but it's hard to get back to those high, heavy weights, especially when you've been doing this for 11 years. That's exactly what I've been doing, is just giving myself some time to recover, let my body just rest, and that's what I did for the last like 8 weeks, basically. And I feel good, my joints feel really good, which is amazing. Even going up in weight quickly, quicker than I should be, I feel no pressure in my joints, I feel no pain, so. That's the best advice I got for you guys. And train heavy and hard, always.
I got a couple of machines that we just used, like the Magnum Row, that I've got coming to my gym. I've got a couple of flex pieces, the incline flex leverage, and this one, hopefully, if Tyler gets his finger out. Hurry up, Tyler, I need it. But these machines, you'll get a chance to use them. This one, I don't know why, it's just hits right. It's perfect, the balance, the leverage on it. Really hits the lats, so it's good to finish on this one.
Good. Now we go. Here we go. Saying it. Out front. No flex. Yep. Yep.
All right, that's a wrap on the hostile back day. I thought a really good, solid session overall. You know, put our minds together there and some exercises and things, you know, wanted to try out. And if you notice there, that you know, the theme of the whole workout was like, with me, you know, because I was kind of picked the structure, is, you know, I like to hit every angle. So when you're training your back, you know, don't neglect any areas. So, you know, we are making sure we hit every angle of, you know, pulling our elbows and hitting every part of our back. Overall, you know, we brought you a lot of, you know, different variations for back offs as well. That's huge. Something I love to do is, you know, hit that top set, lower the weight and do something else to fully finish that exercise, then move on. So, I showed that to Ben and some things, you know, I hope he picked up on today. And overall, it was just fun, man. We had a great session, you know, a great, great time with these two right here. And what do you think, Ben?
Yeah, sorry, I mean.
Are you holding on? Trying to hold on to your lats?
The pump is so much, I'm just holding my arms up right now.
He's having a hard time breathing.
Yeah, it's fucking the best thing. No, the structure is very similar in terms of, if you know me and my training, I do a heavy set and then a back off set and some intensifies. The thing that Brett's putting in are those, I think a lot of you can add in, are those stretch pauses and those extra holds and the tempos and the half from quarter reps. They're really good ways to adjust an exercise. And again, a lot of you know that I talk about progressive overload. Those are ways that you can progressively overload an exercise without necessarily just adding more weight or adding more reps. So again, just gets me thinking, there's different ways to apply to my training, different ways to make the same exercises that I have, because I have a small gym at home. So even if you're limited on the, there's a whole array of exercises out here or equipment that you've got, if you don't have that wide array of choices, you can still make those adjustments, find stimulus to the muscle, changing different techniques and applying different things to the muscle during a set or in a back off set. So there's all different ways. You don't just have to have a mecca of a gym like this to grow a back like Rex. Hi, Bobby.
Ivana?
Yeah, obviously that was an amazing workout. But mostly what I want to say is the whole part of stretching. I feel like a lot of people don't stretch. Even when I'm training my own clients, they're like, wow, I feel so good. I'm like, what have you done differently? And it's just that stretching aspect. So I highly suggest, if you can't do a weight all the way, lower the weight down. Just make sure that you are able to stretch and then actually fully go back into that rep and squeeze at the bottom. So yeah, that was awesome. Feel good. I mean, that was the heaviest that I've personally gone in a while, and it's so great to, you know, train with people who have the same mindset as you and just have a nice little team. So I'm really glad that I got to join today. Hope you guys enjoy the workout. And
yeah, so make sure you like, you know, subscribe, keep commenting. Like I said, this is Christmas is coming up, so next time I'll be making videos or we after Christmas. So I want to kind of get a list of things going on for, you know, January and February for leading into that Arnold show for myself. So make sure you comment below what you guys want to see, so we can, you know, put that together out here in Denver leading up to that. So again, thank you. Thank you for coming out, Ben. It was awesome, you know, putting this, you know, not only the training and doing these YouTubes, but just, you know, being a great friend and everything. So I appreciate that. So everyone have a great Christmas. I don't know what's coming out. Might come out after. I hope you had a great Christmas.
Team Hostile.
Either way, go Team Hostile. We'll see you soon.